Hi, students. Welcome back. We've been talking to Amy Klein about her trip to Paris. You know, Amy, you wrote something that really caught my attention.
What's that, Vicky?
Well, you mentioned that if we really want to experience the true Paris, we shouldn't just look at buildings and museums all the time.
That's right. I think if you don't take time to stop and smell the roses, you're missing an important part of the Paris experience.
But that doesn't seem very easy with only a weekend and so many things to see.
That's true. There is a lot to see, but I'm glad that we did take time to stop and smell the roses.
Now, you mentioned the food was great. I know many things are expensive there. Is the food expensive, too?
The food's a little bit expensive, and the coffee especially.
Okay. Well, they had lots of coffee.
We did.
Well, there's one more place we have to visit in Paris.
You're right, Vicky, and that's the Eiffel Tower. Students, please read along with us as we start on page 16.
The Eiffel Tower. No Paris trip would be complete without a visit to the Eiffel Tower. Our hotel was just a few blocks from the famous tower built for the 1889 World's Fair. Our last night in Paris, we took the elevator to the tower's lofty top. The tower's nighttime view is breathtaking. It helped me understand how Paris earned its nickname as the City of Light. One weekend in Paris isn't enough, so I decided I'll just have to go back someday. But next time, perhaps a French phrasebook would help.
Well, this is a spot I guess no one would want to miss. If you go to Paris, you would feel a little silly if you said, I went to Paris but didn't visit the Eiffel Tower.
That's right. And we were lucky our hotel was right by the Eiffel Tower, so we got to see it several times in the daytime and at night.
Well, there's a beautiful picture of it at night on page 14 in our magazine, and it's one of those world-famous landmarks. You can recognize it from anywhere. If you see a picture, you say, ah, the Eiffel Tower, they must be in Paris.
Of course, Eiffel just comes from a name, someone's name, the man who designed the Eiffel Tower. A tower is a very tall structure, right?
And this fits that. It is an amazingly tall structure. It has the four legs at the base and then goes a long ways into the air. And the views from up there are tremendous.
They certainly are.
Well, it says no Paris trip would be complete without a visit to the Eiffel Tower. Now, that sentence pattern we use a lot, and no something would be complete without something, right? So you can put different things in those spaces.
No meal would be complete without dessert.
Oh,
that's right.
Yeah. Okay, so no trip to Paris. If you go to Paris, it wouldn't be complete if you didn't visit this place.
I would definitely say that's true. And as I said here, our hotel was just a few blocks from the famous tower. And a block is a section of a street that's between two cross streets. And it can include all the buildings and the people who live on that block.
And this tower was not just built because somebody thought, well, it'd be nice to build a big tower. It was actually built for a specific event. In 1889, they were hosting the World's Fair in Paris.
I had no idea that the World's Fair went back this far. I really didn't realize that, but it's pretty amazing because these World's Fairs or World Fairs actually are located in different spots every time, right?
Yeah, they were rotated from country to country, and it was a chance for people to come and show off the new inventions throughout the year. There, a World's Fair is where the television was introduced for the first time in the 1930s. And so this was a very significant event, and if your city was hosting the World's Fair, you did something to try to impress people about your city. That's why this tower was built.
And it certainly did impress people.
It certainly did. That's right. And there are other structures that have been built for the same reason, for the World's Fair. But we do find here that your last night in Paris, we took the elevator to the top.
That's right. We went all the way to the top of the tower. And here I call it the lofty top. And if something is lofty, that just means it's very tall, it's impressively high.
Now, this word can have different meanings depending on the situation. In this case, it does mean that it's very high and towering, right? But sometimes when we talk about something that's rather lofty, it's almost kind of proud or arrogant, right?
Yeah, that can be another meaning that we use for this word. But in this situation, we are talking about something very tall. I sometimes like a little bit of a challenge. Is it possible to walk up there, or does everyone have to take the elevator?
You can take stairs, but I'm not sure if they go all the way up. That would take a long time.
And Kirby, if I remember right, you're afraid of heights like I am. I'm not sure you'd go very far.
I am too.
I forgot about that. You're right.
So that didn't frighten you going up in the elevator?
Actually, it did. Melissa made fun of me for that.
Oh.
You know, we got to the top and I just didn't want to get too close to the edge.
It's like, tell me about it. I'll close my eyes.
Yeah.
I stood closer to the back where it was safe and looked down. And then Melissa went closer and was taking pictures.
Well, one of the things you will want to do up there, obviously, is be safe and take pictures of this breathtaking view.
Right, this breathtaking view, sometimes we say something takes our breath away. It's so amazing. So this breathtaking view is just very inspiring. You might be in awe of something like this.
That's right. You might stop breathing for a minute, you know, because it's so amazing.
And you say, it helped me understand how Paris earned its nickname as the City of Light. So to earn a nickname, there's something that's significant about you or unique about you or a place that earns its nickname.
And you say that one weekend isn't enough, so you've decided that you're going to go back someday. But there's one thing you're going to bring with you.
Next time I will take a French phrase book. That's one thing we forgot.
Right, a phrase book that gives you little phrases that you could memorize and use in French. Probably a pretty smart thing to do. Mm-hmm. Well, thank you for our look at Paris with Amy. And now let's review what we've learned today.
Hi, everyone. 我是 Michelle. 第一个我们来看的是 stop and smell the roses 这个动词片语。 从字面上来看是停下来闻闻玫瑰花，延伸出来的意思就是指放松一下来享受生活。例如 Dave has been working so hard all week. It's time for him to stop and smell the roses. Dave 整个星期以来都非常努力的工作，他是应该放松一下来享受人生的时候了。另外一个和 smell 还有 rose 都有关的片语是 smell like roses。 意思就是像玫瑰花一样香，也就是闻起来很香。例如 ，After taking a bath, the baby smelled like roses. 小宝宝泡个澡之后香喷喷了。接下来我们看的是 Parisian 这个名词，注意 s 在这里是发 r 的音，而且重音是在 ri 的地方，所以整个念起来是 Parisian。Parisian 在这里是名词，就是指巴黎人或巴黎居民。 它也可以当形容词，是指巴黎的，或者是和巴黎有关的。只有少数的大城市的人有这个殊荣，可以有专属的名称。例如，纽约的居民叫做 New Yorker，也有人说纽约客。再来看的是 breathtaking 这个形容词，我们之前有学过 take someone's breath away 这个动词片语，就是令人惊艳或倾倒。而 breathtaking 是一个形容词，意思就是令人惊艳的、令人倾倒的。 例如 ，This hotel is famous for its breathtaking view. 这家旅社以令人惊艳的景观而闻名。Okay, that's all for this article. I'll see you next time. Goodbye.